Okay, quick quiz for you folks. Where are we? Well, aside from the giveaway livery, you can easily tell that we're in Amsterdam because it's belting it down with rain. What a surprise! On the map, you'll see we are heading to the warmer climes of Kilimanjaro, obviously famous for its mountain down in Africa. Is it Kenya? No, Tanzania. Oh, jeez, I forget which bloody country it's in now. That's where we're going. I'll find out where Kilimanjaro is in due course. It is, it's in Kenya, just south of Nairobi. There we go. See, wait a minute, it's over the border in Tanzania, actually. I was right. There we go. I knew I was in the right ballpark. I said one of those two countries, so I feel like I've redeemed myself. Anyway, let's get this plane underway. See, I do know some geography, believe it or not. Parking brakes are set. Yep. Battery switch on. Let's go to the overhead stuff for that. Instrument panel. I'm not sure which instrument panel I need, to be honest. Trial and error. I think it's about 7, isn't it? Let's try that, shall we? What a guess. There we go. So, what did we say? We said battery switch on. There we go. Maybe generator switch off. Flaps. Speed brakes off. Off check. Anti-ice controls on auto. We'll put the APU switch on, actually. Anti-ice controls on auto. There we are. Window heating as required. Attitude settings set. Set. Beacon lighting on. Seatbelt sign on. I'll get the fuel switches on as well, actually, as we've got those on. There we go. Fuel switches are all on. Seatbelt sign on. Fuel quantity checked. Check the brake. Yaw dampener is on, wherever that is. I can never find the yaw dampener on this thing, so. Probably more down on the main control thing. We'll look at that a bit later. Thermostats and hydraulic pumps are all on. There we go. AC packs on. Yeah, packs auto, trim air on. That's all good. Static clearance request, AP master on. We did do all that, didn't we? Right, let's come down to the main panel and let's program up the FMC. Yeah, it's not that. It's not that. Oh, is there a yaw dampener down here by any chance? It might be. You'd expect this is where the yaw dampener then is. It's. Can't see it anywhere. Okay, let's go three. There we are. I knew it was one of these. So, init ref, we are in. We're in Amsterdam, obviously. Eham. There we go. GPS position, bang. Legs, yeah. Depart. Just make sure, let's run through and make sure that's all correct. I think it's all set up. Depart, arrive. Arrival, C set, approach 9, yeah. Index, departure. And departure. I think we've got it set up for runway 18 anyway. Legs nav radio, yeah, that's cool. Gotta set the altitude and stuff as well. Go to the performance page, that's the other one we need to do because we're cruising altitude of 37,000 feet. There we go. Cost index is also going to be 40, and our reserves we should put in as such, thrust limits, G1, takeoff flaps, 5 degrees, and it's all set, yeah, brilliant, awesome, okay, let's do it a little bit, Okay, brilliant. So we're ready to push back. We are, of course, departing from runway 18 centre today. Did give me 18 right, I just didn't. Could not connect to simulator. Don't give me that crap. I need to connect to the simulator. Sim connect. This is annoying. I've updated Navigraph and. No, it won't connect up. Don't be a pain in the backside, will you? Come on. Sim connect. Connect. I've got a Simlink. That's it, Simlink. That's the one I want to connect, actually. Sim connect, Simlink. There we go. Brilliant. We're back in business. Okay, the slight technical glitch there, which we have resolved, I'm pleased to say. We're going to push back shortly. In fact, let's push back now. Actually, no, let's not do that. What are we cruising today at 37,000 feet? Let's plug that in. Get this set up first before we do any of this stuff. 37,000 feet. Yeah, flight director's on. That's all good. Auto throttle, yeah. Oh, nav, VS. Set that up. Okay, let's get ourselves pushing back then. Take the brakes off. As we prepare to depart out from a unsurprisingly miserable, wet, rainy Schiphol Airport here in Amsterdam for our flight down to Kilimanjaro in Tanzania. Unfortunately, it's likely to be dark by the time we get there. Every time I've flown to Kilimanjaro, because of the flight time scheduling, it always tends to be dark, and I always tend to fly, end up getting rostered there in the winter months as well. So at some point, it would be nice to see in the daytime. But such is the life of a flight sim pilot. Okay, let's start the engines up. Hopefully we can see the fuel coming in. Yes, we can. Now, I haven't used the Dreamliner since Sim Update 6, and they are supposed to have done some work on it, so I'd be interested to see how it handles and things like taxiing and so on, but we shall wait and see what we get with that. Big old engines powering themselves up now. We prepare for our departure out from Amsterdam. Flight time, I meant to say, was in the region of, I think, about 7.5 hours or something. Now it's 14, so we'll check that out in a minute. Yes, the flight time is, no, sorry, just shy of 8 hours. 8 hour flight time. Obviously I use accelerated time, so you won't be watching an 8 hour video. Okay, so let's just hop back to our overhead view. Let's make sure we've got everything on that needs to be on. So we got full startup, so we've got all the hydraulics are on, beacon on, nav on, runway and taxi lights can come on. We've got obviously the generators on, master hob can be turned off for the APU, that's cool. We'll set the flaps in a minute. Everything else looks pretty good for what I need. Fuel pumps are all on, we'll just come down, check our screen. Parking brake is set. That is seriously belting it down here in Schiphol now. Look at that rain coming, lashing down. Get the flaps in position. There we go, flaps are set. Lights all good. And I think we can start our... Is there any weather radar-y things I need to turn on, is there? Probably is somewhere. Just put my fuel off. Ah, now look at this for turning. Oh, this is better. Look at this. It's actually turning. Oh, that's much better. I used to have nightmares with that. Now that's progress, I guess. Obviously it'll go a bit quicker once I straighten up. That feels like it's pretty ready. This rain is really epic. I should really put the wipers on if I find where they are. Heaters. So where are the bloody wipers on this thing? Oh, there. Stick them on in a minute. This rain, look at it, it is really heavy. What a miserable day here in Amsterdam. Yeah, well, we'll be pleased to depart out, that's for sure. Ah, the weather radar's there. Cool. Turn that on in a minute. Make a right turn at the end as we taxi on up to the end of 18 Center. We bid farewell. Where did we go previous to Kilimanjaro? I think we went across to Beijing or something, wasn't it? I believe. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, shit, I've turned onto the wrong taxiway. As we're going to end up backtracking along the runway here. It's my own stupid fault. We can come off at another taxiway and then track back along, I think, because I'm not... Probably not going to be able to spin it around on the runway. So yeah, let's exit here. That's a bit stupid, wasn't it? Total dumbass. It's not paying attention. Anyway, we get to practice how good this plane is at taxiing now, and I have to say, I certainly think it's an improvement. Still not easy. But you can certainly turn it a lot sharper than you used to be able to, that's for sure. And without having to, I used to have to really pump the rudder to get it to turn. You know, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, etc., etc. And, oh no, wait a minute, well, what's going on here? I thought we were on the runway, now we're on some other second taxiway. Oh, this is getting ridiculous now. Anyway, we'll stay on here and just go up to the end, shall we? Because we want to get in the air now. I think I've shown you the taxiing capabilities of this aircraft enough. Oh no, that's just some little road thing. Okay, cool. Right, so we need to take not this left, but the next left. There's a taxiway around the back of this runway, by the way. Doesn't come back into it, though. So anyway, let's get ready to say farewell to a dingy, miserable, wet, yucky Amsterdam. And I mean, it's not great, folks, is it? I like Amsterdam. But one of the things I remember from the many times I've been there is the weather is quite similar to where I am in the UK, actually. It's like a home from home in that respect. Oh, looking a little bit clearer there. Looking like some of the weather is lifting. Anyway, we are lined up, ready to go. We can switch things on, like, I don't know, the weather. There we go, yes, there we go. Oh, hello. That's interesting. Oh, well, it had a set departure then. 18 centre. Hold on, let's just set that up then. That's right to do it. Depart. Okay, we're departing from 18 centre. Yeah. Not using any SIDs. Execute legs. There we go, you'll see that now has an appropriate thing. Cool, brilliant. Those are all enabled. Our main strobes are on, and we want main lights on. As we prepare for our takeoff, flaps all set. Alright, folks. Speed alive. Hundred knots. Still behaves very much like a light aircraft, I have to say, there from that takeoff we just witnessed. Very much like it. Let's put the autopilot on. Let's put LNAV, let's shove VNAV on. Making that left turn. Keep an eye on what the plane's doing. Feel a lot happier if we got a bit faster. There we go, increasing speed and altitude again. Flaps can come up, lights off. Okay, we're really climbing at a ridiculous rate now. Set Q and H to standard barrow. Set. There we go. And then we'll pop into the wing view. We'll put the gear up and the flaps up and everything. Pop into the showcase view. Fix camera. There we go. See you folks on the other side. Okay, welcome back. We'll soon be beginning our descent down into Kilimanjaro. We need to get some inside lighting on in here, don't we? Oops. There we go. It's a kid. Overhead lighting, overhead panel. There we go, it's a bit bright, isn't it? And there we go. Awesome. So, ladies and gentlemen, why are we flying so slowly? Get that. So as you can see, it's pretty dark out there. We are approaching down into Kilimanjaro. Still need to fix those thunderstorms, don't they? Although we have got some weather on our radar, so it is entirely plausible. I mean, fuel wise, how we've. Jeez, has actually used up any fuel at all? It's more like 90. That's ridiculous. I don't think the fuel usage is calculated right on this at all. There's a 787 mod in here on this. Jeez, I didn't realise we're so far out. Tell you what I'm going to do, I'm just going to accelerate the time a little. Otherwise we'll be waiting forever. Okay. We'll begin our descent down to... What altitude do we need? 6,100 feet. And we begin our descent. Ascent. Minute on Philippine Airlines, there we go. They're saying my last flight, how I last got to Hong Kong, that's from Manila on Philippine Airlines, guest airline. We're of course now, my next guest airline, we're back to China, Southern, so we're flying in China. Forget the names of the destinations, but that's where we'll be. Shame we're flying to such a reasonably remote area because we're not, and it's overcast because we're not really going to be able to see any of the updated night lighting, which is supposed to be vastly improved from, I keep thinking that compass is the moon for some weird reason, out the corner of my eye. Um, Yeah, they're supposed to have updated it, improved it in terms of its, so it's not just those light lit up blobs as much. So anyway, we've got freeware Kilimanjaro, so we should hopefully have some airport lighting. Funny enough, a place in Japan I flew into, Ishigaki, the freeware airport's just been updated, didn't realise, otherwise I downloaded it. So, yeah, not the nicest weather here in Africa, as you can see. It's that song about the rains of Africa. There's me saying, when we departed Schiphol, that we were going to fly somewhere like sunnier, well, it's warmer, at least, but it's still chucking it. Just imagine, I'm fed up this weather in Amsterdam, let's go to Africa. They arrive in Africa and it's still peeing down the rain. As I said already, we are flying into Tanzania. Kilimanjaro, the highest, I believe the highest mountain in Africa. It's up to about 15,000 feet. Unfortunately, we won't see anything of it because we're flying at night, which is a bit frustrating. One day we'll see it in the daytime. Maybe when we depart back out to Amsterdam, it'll give me a daytime flight. Hold on, we've got some lighting down there. Can you see that? At 24,000 feet and descending. So we only need to drop down to 6,000 feet, so we're pretty comfortable with that. Arm there, isn't it? There we go. And we'll make a left turn shortly. And so, sure what this lighting is down here. Say Kilimanjaro up to about 15,000 feet. It's a huge, huge mountain. So we're almost down to the same level as it, because we're only at 21,000 feet. Just over, so if we put the terrain radar on, you'll probably see it start to. What's about a little loop background, huh? Not sure what that's all about. So I'm not sure what approach it's going to bring me in on here, actually. Tisov. It's here. And then it's got like this loopy stuff, whatever that's about. Oh, we may have to vector ourselves. Not that big. So after T-Solve, we got. Try and understand what's going on here. So, first things first, let's ease that rate of descent. Can't I see it? Oh, because it's behind the speed. Speed brake lever. Wonderful. Right. USSR. Or USR. What the hell is USR? In relation to anything. Huh. I already got USR twice. So yeah, we'll probably just direct ourselves straight in, because I don't think it works if you muck around with that. So we'll just vector ourselves in from TSOV. We'll use this map to help me do that. So Kilimanjaro just off to our ahead and off to our left. What runway does it think we're landing at? Because it wants me to branch off and go some really weird... Got the RS plugged in. Crap, why not? It's 110.9. Really? Right, there we go, brilliant. Double check that. Set towards break up. Logo on. Ah, and I've taken super signs off. Never mind, I can leave those on. Where's the local Q&H? So run 3, oh, that's handy. Just leave it as it is. Success feet. Ah, I got something that's too high. Let the plane down. Set ourselves down to that speed brake's way too effective. Ok, KL is there. I can see the ground. Nice. Set lights on. Made a right mess of this approach, right mess. I can't believe what a mess we made of that approach. Never mind. Okay, let's try and do a decent landing. Their angle of attack looks totally wrong. Way too high, don't we? Did I put the Yeah, I did. On. It's all good. We just look stupidly high. Tell you what, we are stupidly high. Let's take the auto throttle off. Because we are way, way too high. Sure, what's going on with the I knew something was wrong. Look how high we are. We're like on a freaking lift. Man, nose diving the plane down pretty much. There, we can come up a little bit now, can't we? There we go. That's it, now we're looking better. Float, float, float. More floating. Okay, there's no way to turn around, brilliant. Oh, they're at the end here. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Kilimanjaro, where we're now going to try and turn a freaking massive plane around. With minimal space. Yeah, not really happening, is it? I don't know how I expected this to ever work. The freaking great Dreamliner. A little bit of rain coming down. That's really quite awkward in the dark. It was a very untidy approach and landing. Not very happy with that, to be honest. I've got to go and take the dog out, so I'll have to do a little break before we replay. It's annoying me. Well, you can see the lights there, that's pretty cool. We'll just park up in front of the terminal here. Oh, there is a space there, that's cool. There we go. Brakes on, engines off. .149 landing rate. Oh, that's cool. Alright, I have to come back for replay.